What is a permutation in group theory? As opposed to a permutation, say, in probability. Might be worth remembering what a permutation in probability is. A permutation in probability, or you could say discrete math, is an ordering of a set of objects. Is the same idea in abstract algebra in group theory? Kind of. There's a relationship, but it's we technically not an actual ordering or in the intuitive way that we typically think about it. It's an ordering defined by a function. A permutation in group theory is it's a one-to-one, 1-1, and onto function from a set to itself. That's what a permutation is in group theory, a one-to-one and onto function from a set to itself. What set? We're not saying. Could be any set, any non-empty set. A non-empty set to itself. How is this related to group theory? With this idea, you can define the idea of a group of permutations. A group of permutations is a collection of permutations, a set of permutations that forms a group under function composition. Is a set of permutations, a collection of them, a collection of functions, the elements are functions, that forms a group under function composition. That's what a group of permutations is. This group could be an infinite group. You could have infinitely many permutations in your set. That's a possibility, but it's a possibility we don't really think about in here. We think about finite groups of permutations based on sets of permutations whose domain and codomain is a finite set. Our main example is called SN. It's called the symmetric group on N objects. On N objects. What objects? They can be anything, could be a group of n people, could be a group of n stars. Well, why don't we just keep it simple? The n objects are usually taken to be 1 through n. Note this is not Zn, this is not U of n, this is not the set 1 through n is not a group. What's the group? The group Sn, the symmetric group on n objects, is the group of all permutations on this set. One-to-one and onto functions from the set to itself. Functions that, for example, might map 2 to 5 and 5 to 7 and 7 back to 3 cycles. As an example, well, I should say this is a group of all permutations of the elements of the set. For example, S3, the group of all permutations on three objects. Your three objects being, we say, 1, 2, and 3. The elements of S3 are going to be functions. There's the function that maps everything to itself, the identity function. In this context, typically called epsilon. In cycle notation, that could be written just as, say, a 1 by itself, indicating you map 1 to 1, 2 and 3 don't show up, so it's assumed that 2 gets mapped to 2 and 3 gets mapped to 3. We could map 1 to 2 and 2 to 1 and 3 to itself. This cycle would represent that function. 1 gets mapped to 2, 2 gets mapped to 3, 2 gets mapped back to 1, and 3 gets mapped to itself. You work from left to right, and then when you get to the end, you go back to the beginning. 1 gets mapped to 2, 2 gets mapped back to 1, 3 is not shown, so 3 gets mapped to itself. We could also do 2, 3, 1, 3, and there's two more. 2, 3 cycles, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 3, 2. This means 1 gets mapped to 2, 2 gets mapped to 3, and 3 gets mapped back to 1. This means 1 gets mapped to 3, 3 gets mapped to 2, and 2 gets mapped back to 1. And there are no others. These six functions are the functions in this symmetric group on three objects. We might be interested in what's its group structure under function composition. What does its Cayley table look like?